Welcome to the Why Not Show, where we believe that if others can, you definitely can. If others can, you definitely can. It has been a while. It has been just a minute ever since we made our inspiration. But here we are. We still have a lot loaded somewhere, but we will upload soon. Today, we are speaking about insecurities. Insecurities can be in a job. It can be in your life. It can be on your body. It can be in your relationship. Like, you can be insecure about anything. In some definitions, they said insecurities is a lack of confidence. You lack confidence. Like, you are not confident about whatever you're going to attack. You don't have that, I don't know, the guts to actually go for something. Because sometimes, I'll give you examples from my own experience, because sometimes you feel like you are not good enough. Sometimes you feel like... I don't know how to describe it, but if you've ever been there and you're still there, you know what I'm trying to say and you know what I'm trying to mean. Giving an example of my heya and examples of a lot of black people. We often want to put on wigs or to plait our hair to look good, yeah? But most times we do it because we feel we are not good enough. We don't look so well. Like, wait, if you put on an extra layer of a wig, you look much better. And that will help you actually deal with the insecurities of yourself, with the insecurities that you have. Not so sad. Yeah. So people think that it helps you, and it really
does,
because if you see, I rarely put my hair out. I recently cut it a little bit because they say if you cut it, it will grow back again, which I don't know if that theory is actually right. But we have a lot of insecurities in a lot of things, and it is okay. It is normal. But how do you deal with it? Because, like, you can't live your life every day feeling you are not enough, feeling you are... Sometimes people actually feel they're too much for something. That is why one time I said that you can't dim your light. You can't dim your light just to fit in. Like, you go in the room where everyone is somehow, and you go, you're outstanding, and then you try to shrink so as to fit in. If you don't fit in, just move out and look for another crowd. Yes, sometimes you need it when you've really gone there. But most times you don't have to do that to fit in. Let people upgrade their standard to reach at where you are. Because I know for sure you also have to upgrade your standard to reach at some people's level, not some people's level, to reach at a level that you actually want. Like, because that is life. You can't just say, I've reached here and that is it. You have to keep climbing, you have to keep going, and over and over and over and over again. Not so sad. You have to keep going. So we deal with insecurities in many ways. And don't let that insecurity that you have... Most people have insecurities in their relationships because you feel people out there are much better than you, and you can't be good enough for your partner. An example, when I was dating my husband, I used to tell him, because, you know, we dated online, and I used to tell him, you know what, I'm small, I'm very, very small. I don't know if you like me. I think when you come here, you'll come, and then someone else takes your attention, because I know some people are really good at putting themselves there, you know. Someone will take your attention, and you take that person. And he just kept saying, I don't care. And I just kept saying it to him so that he doesn't come and then, oh, I don't like him because he's small. Like, I did it to make sure that he knows what he's going for. So we are insecure in many ways with your body. And you body shame yourself, not even someone else to do it for you. You body shame yourself. You body shame yourself. And you feel other people will come and take away whatever you have. But I came to an understanding that whatever you have, whatever God allows you to have, is yours. And however much it will take 1,000 years to reach to you, it will definitely come. However much it will take to come to you, it will definitely come. It will definitely show up. I was watching a movie recently. It's called The Intern. And this lady is a very successful lady. And the husband, so much. So due to that, the husband went ahead and got another woman. Started cheating, you know. Started cheating because he felt this lady is too much for him and he doesn't have time for him. Which the lady recognized, and when the company had a chance to get another CEO, the lady offered to step down so that the lady offered to step down so that her marriage doesn't fall apart. Her husband doesn't go away. But we compromise in marriages, no? But if it is something that is helping both of you in some way, anyway, I'm not a marriage counselor to speak in these things, but I'm just saying the lady had to step down from her dream, the one she built when she was very, very young, to the level it was at, just to, you know, just to go and be with the husband so that the husband doesn't cheat. And thank God, this husband was very understanding and he came and he was, don't step down for me. Like, it is just compromising. But then my point is, you want to shrink yourself to a lot of things and you want to change yourself in a lot of ways just to fit in. Just to fit in, just to be enough. I don't know who tells you that you're not enough. I don't know who says that in your ears every day. I want to confirm to you that you are enough. It is not a lie. You are enough. You can't be like me. I can't be like you. You can't be like we want to compare ourselves many times to a lot of people. Not just our bodies. Oh, my baby's like this. Now this one is baby is like. Like, you compare a lot of things. You compare whatever you have to other people, you know. And you think that comparing yourself will bring you satisfaction. Never. Because you can compare yourself with someone else, maybe with a beautiful house or beautiful home or beautiful life. And guess what? After that, you have another thing also to compare yourself with. I'm not saying that you be contented. No, don't be contented at all. Just keep moving to the best heights that you can go to. But don't allow the insecurities in your mind take away the joys that you're supposed to have. You cease from enjoying the moment because you're thinking about how big you could be, how beautiful you could be. Like, you just take away the moment of joy from you because you want to be someone else. Because you want to be something else. What? So there's no joy in that. So today, be you. Fight those insecurities. Fight them. Fight those insecurities, just like today. You see, I'm having my natural hair. Rare. But that is when you start to understand that you're putting in a lot of struggle. You know, you have to put in a lot of money, you have to put in a lot of work, you have to put in a lot of time just to try to be like someone else. Why don't you just keep your natural self? Just comb your hair, wash it, and that's it. I'm assuming about hair, but you know what I mean. It also relates to other parts of your life. Don't complicate your life. Don't complicate yourself just because you're insecure. That is it for today. Search into the one who show where we believe that if others can, you definitely can. For us on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, and YouTube. Bye.